Okay, we're going to talk about feeding some horses in pasture here. I just threw some hay to these guys. If you notice, when I threw them their hay, I made sure it wasn't by a fence and it wasn't by a gate. Plenty of room around all these guys. Now, another thing you're going to notice here is that I put the pile in one pile. And I tell people, don't do that, because you get horses fighting. The reason why I did this is my two horses always eat together, because they've learned to share, and horses will share if they're broken in right. If I just threw this out here and had never fed these horses before, the lead horse would get protective. He'd be kicking all the other horses. The other horses would keep me trying to fight in, and you'd have all kind of problems. But since these guys have been taught to share, they've been taught to fed, and they've been worked up to this point, I can throw the hay in one pile and the horses can eat it. Again, I see people, they want to throw the hay right on the other side of a fence because it's easy. Because they ain't got to walk their butt out to pasture. God knows there ain't enough skinny people in the horse world that they can't afford to lose a few calories, including me, and walk out to the pasture or walk out past that gate and get some exercise and bring your horses some hay where it's safe, it's better for them, and you can control the environment. The reason why it's important to have horses way out in the open like this is if these horses want to push or get in a little squabble or somebody gets too pushy, you want to be able to... Buddy thinks I have a carrot in my hand. I do have carrots, and I gave him some earlier. So he's like, I don't need the hay. I'll just come over here and get in your way. Go on. Go eat. Go on. Go on. Go eat. So, again, you couldn't see that, but she just kind of told Buddy... Lacey, the brown horse right here on the right, just told Buddy, don't get too close. See her? She's scratching right now. And although they can eat together, there's still going to be a little ear pinning. There's still going to be communication. There's still going to be respect issues. If one of these horses try to go over and grab grass out of the other horse's mouth, there's going to be problems. But they're going to work it out. They've learned to share. They've learned that they've been fed this way. And they're not starving horses. They're not hungry. You know, I see people, they get these rescues, they throw them out in a herd. These horses are skinny, they're weak, they can't eat, and they throw hay out there in the middle and say, oh, I'll give them hay. Well, the stronger horses, the ones that have been eating, are probably going to take it. Even if they don't want it, it's just a dominance thing. So train your horses to eat together by feeding them together. Slowly, the way I got these guys to do this, of course, Buddy and Tanner, they've kind of grown up together, and Tanner's beat Buddy's butt several times for not showing him respect, and then Tanner allowed him to come in when he did the right way. Now, Buddy can reach over there and grab something right out of Tanner's mouth, and Tanner probably won't do anything. Because they have a clearly established relationship that Tanner knows if he says enough, it's enough. Buddy knows when he says enough, he's going to back away. But he will still push and test and try to move up, because that's what horses do. And Lacey is the mare, so she usually gets to come in. Tanner will let her come in. So if she pushes Buddy off, Tanner probably won't say anything. These horses are all eating one pile of hay. I kind of spread it out a little bit in the middle there. Again, they've been taught. I wouldn't feed this the first time, and I wouldn't throw a pile of hay like this in the middle of a herd. Feeding horses in a herd, get more horses hurt, and then the next thing you know, you got people saying, oh, I can't feed my horses together. I got to lock them up in a stall. They fight. They bite each other. They're going to get a broken leg. Look, horses are going to be horses. These horses can eat here, and it's not because they're special. It's not because they got some special breeding or special colors or any of that stuff. They've been set up for success. They've been taught how to share and how to eat. And I've done that by, I fed them in separate piles, and I slowly got the piles closer over time. And they learned to push a little bit. And then after a while, they're like, you know what? We're going to get food every day. We got in a routine. There's really no reason to push. We don't need to fight for our food. And so if they don't need to fight, they won't. And like with a lot of things of horses, once they figure out they don't have to do something, they normally won't do it. But it's same way with tearing down a fence. You know, if you put a horse in a shabby fence and they learn to put their head over, they're going to learn to test every fence. If you feed a horse in one pile and they start learning to fight, they're going to learn to fight. They're going to learn to get protective because they weren't set up for success and fed right. So feeding horses in the pasture, it's a lot more natural. You notice I didn't set that grass on dirt. I see people throwing a lot of grass on the dirt. That's not good. That'll cause sand colic. That'll get your horse's belly full of dirt and sand. And that's not good for them. So if you're going to feed them in pasture, I always try to pick a grassy spot. You can lay a tarp down and do a little sacking out, and they can walk on the tarp and eat it. A lot of times they'll pick it up and throw it. You can put a tire on top of a piece of plywood and that'll keep it off the ground. But you don't really want to feed on dirt and sand with horses. It's not good for them. They got great dexterity in their lips, but they're still going to pick up a little dirt. So that's feeding horses in the pasture, things to consider and how to break them in to get horses to eat peacefully. And you see there's no fighting. These guys are, their heads together, they're eating nice, they're still picking around the hay, picking good hay, but there's harmony in a herd because there's no reason for there not to be. They've been set up for success and they've been taught that they're going to get fed and there's really no reason to fight. So I hope that helps feeding your horses and herd.